ko Waiahau, ko Whakapūnake te Maunga, ko Wairoa te Awa, ko Ngāti Kahungunu te Iwi, ko Ngai te Apatū te Hapū, ko Rhys Jones tōku ingoa. So I'm Rhys, I'm from Wairoa in the Hawke's Bay, that's where my whānau is from, and grew up down in Napier. I've trained as a doctor here at the University of Auckland, and subsequent to that I worked in Napier for a while, and then overseas as a junior doctor before I got into public health medicine, and so I've trained as a public health medicine specialist. I think the phrase critic and conscience really does have a strong meaning for me. It's not something that I always, you know, use in day-to-day conversations, but it is something that kind of characterises a lot of the work that I do. The critic part of that, very importantly, I think, is part of particularly being an academic in the area of Māori health. You know, because I think sometimes a lot of the dominant discourse around Māori health, the fact that, you know, Māori smoke too much, drink too much, all these individual lifestyle factors or personal choices are responsible for the bad health outcomes that we see. That dominant discourse really needs to be questioned and challenged, and I think that's where the role of a critic comes into it. From an academic perspective, when we have a broader understanding about, you know, social determinants of health, about the way factors at different levels of society create environments in which people's choices are either constrained or, you know, allowed, then we have a better understanding of, well, it's not just individual choice or individual responsibility, and so we can provide a critique of the dominant discourse and provide other ways of looking at those things. Mm. I think sometimes there is a tension between the critic and conscience role and the imperative of sort of maintaining scientific objectivity. But I think that our role as academics, and I think this is also supported by what's in the Education Act, is that we have a responsibility to go beyond just publishing our results and putting the evidence out there, but actually we're required to, and I think have a responsibility to challenge things that we see as inconsistent with the evidence. For example, in the area of climate change and health, we see huge evidence around the harmful impacts of climate change on health, but also B, the huge benefits that are possible from acting to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and particularly some of the health benefits that can come from things like you know, more active transport, change in diets, healthier housing, things like that. And so where the evidence is really so clear that, you know, we're heading in the wrong direction, I think we have a responsibility to not just say this is what the evidence is, but actually to say our policies and our sort of trajectory in terms of what we're doing about climate change is taking us in totally the wrong direction, and we need to align what we're doing with what the evidence is telling us. I think being a Māori academic and being an Indigenous person definitely changes the way I think you approach academic activities. I know certainly as I've gone on in my academic career, I've become more kind of grounded in a kaupapa Māori way of doing things. And one of the really important principles from a kaupapa Māori perspective is that whatever you're doing should be of benefit to Māori. So I'm always very conscious of the fact that my role and my responsibility here at the university is not just about producing the, you know, the academic outputs, but also about, and most importantly, about making things better for Māori and for everyone.